Looking for a trainer for your pet can be an overwhelming experience. Not all trainers are the same, with vast differences in their level of education, experience, training methods used, and standards by which they are governed. These differences affect their influence on the animals they train, and unfortunately, in some situations, can cause more harm than good. That's why it's essential to take extra care in finding the right trainer to work with your pet. Avoid trainers who use fear and force. These outdated training methods have been scientifically proven to be less effective in comparison to training that's rooted in the use of rewards and can even damage emotional stability and the human-animal bond. To avoid trainers using these methods, keep an eye out for words like dominant, dominance, alpha dog, pack leadership, submissive state, dominance hierarchy, or advising you have to be the boss of your dog. Avoid trainers who use a mix of training methods, such as utilizing treats at times, while at other times using fear and force. This is never necessary and only delays learning and creates conflict and confusion for the animal learner. Avoid trainers who recommend or utilize choke chains, pinch collars, electronic shock collars, and other physical punishment devices and methods. Avoid trainers who don't have an open door policy. You should always be welcome to be a part of training, and there should never be any secrets. Avoid trainers who guarantee their results. With so many variables that affect the outcome of training, such as genetics of the animal, their temperament, and owner commitment and owner experience, it's impossible for an ethical animal trainer to guarantee success. There are also some things that you can keep an eye out for as you identify a trainer that's a good fit for you and your pet. Your trainer should utilize only humane training methods which promote and protect the human-animal relationship and are not harmful to the animal or to their human guardians in any way. Training should safeguard both the animal's physical and emotional well-being. Your trainer should utilize positive reinforcement to reward animals for what they're doing right, rather than punishing for perceived misbehavior. Such trainers may use methods like clicker training or food lures to train new behaviors. Your trainer should set animals up for success by gradually building up to situations at a level that keeps the pet's emotional comfort and behavioral success continually in mind. In the end, you want a trainer who makes the training feel fun and promotes feelings of happy relaxation for you and your pet. If something feels wrong about a situation with the trainer, don't be afraid to question what's being done with your pet, especially if it's causing your animal to react fearfully, to shut down, or to otherwise show signs of stress. Your trainer should be a certified member of a professional training organization. Keep in mind that not all certifying agencies and educational courses are created equal. A list of recommended certifications and accreditations can be found on our website. Each of these, as well as Fear-Free's own animal trainer certification, have directories to help you find local trainers. Or you can ask your pet's veterinarian for their recommendations for reward-based trainers in your area. Your selected trainer should also recognize the value of education and attend continuing education seminars regularly. If your animal has a specific training need, you may wish to seek out a trainer who specializes in the specific skill set or specialty you're looking for. Your trainer should work alongside veterinary professionals. Veterinarians are exclusively responsible for diagnosing behavioral disorders, for medical and behavioral differential diagnosis, and for prescribing a treatment plan, which may include pharmacological intervention. Your trainer should provide a safe and disease-free location for training, having appropriate protocols in place to prevent infectious disease transmission, including vaccine and health guidelines for group participants, and having disinfecting and sanitizing protocols in place. While finding a great trainer can be a bit overwhelming, it's important to find one that's going to have a positive impact on you and your pet for your ultimate journey toward a fear-free, happy home.